People who were taken as the prisoners, majority of them accept Islam. If Islam treat them badly, why they accept Islam? Not just accept Islam, they fought for Islam. Some of them become scholars in Islam to show you Islam, to show them justice. But now, because of liberalism, now many Muslims have been affected by this liberalism ideology.
Yes.
So alhamdulillah, you agree, Allah bless you. Many of them, they think, that is Dana. Whatever Allah legislates is good for us without any doubt. But look to the contradiction, my sister, yeah? Like I said, they make it seem they care about women, but there's many women, I watched the commentary. There's a woman that she was saying, I don't want to go and sell my body, but I feel I've been forced because of society. But no one cares about them. They say, no, she's free. On the other hand, what happened to our Muslim sisters in Iraq by the British army and the American army? Why no one speaks about them? What is liberalism now?
I don't know if they have to.
Because America went there to teach us what? To teach us liberalism. You see, my sister? So alhamdulillah, in Islam, if it's needed, yeah, but in our time, can that happen? Allah knows best, but doesn't mean it doesn't exist anymore. If it did happen, like I said, it's for the Muslim leader. And Allah, my sister, Allah said, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah knows what is good for his creation and what is not. Islam, first, let me make it clear to you. No man, no woman should enslave no one. That's the origin. No man, no woman, no one should enslave no one. No one should enslave no one. That's the us, that's the foundation. Why? Because Adam was created as a free man. Hawa, she was a free woman. You understand? When I say free, not according to liberalism definition. Free means she was a servant of Allah, worshipping Allah, not following her desires. That's not free woman or free man. So now, in a war, servitude starts becoming known amongst nations. Everybody was enslaving everybody. Islam comes in and eliminates the wrong one and keep the right one with the conditions. So the only time in a war, but if you take them, in Islam, if you have a servant, it's upon the Muslim to help him to free himself. Imagine the Muslim raising money for this man to help him. Savi kul mukataba, what is mukataba? He's my leader. So I said, look, I want to leave. He said, okay, let us. Give me some money back and I will let you. I said, okay, this money. So the Muslim says, Allah mentioned the Quran. The Muslim raises money and give it to the servant and he walk away free. That never happened in no history. So no one tried to compare transatlantic slavery to Islam. That's what's happening now. People, when they speak about servitude and slavery, straight away, you try to compare it to transatlantic slavery. No, that's not Islamic one. You understand? So that is out of necessity. But the asl, man is free. Woman is free. Again, not according to liberalism. Free means to be servant of Allah. No one is, you're not in charge of no one. Except the husband and the wife, that's how it goes. Do you understand that? Like for example, husband and the wife, the husband is in charge, and doesn't mean the husband should become a tyrant or should rebel, should oppress his wife. Rather, in charge, he has a responsibility to protect her, take care of her, look after her. You understand? Because the end of the day, she's his sister in Islam. You understand? And the Prophet Muhammad said, the best of you, best of their wives. And the Prophet Muhammad, before he died, he said, I advise you to take care of the prayer and to take care of what your right hand possess. Prophet Muhammad said, if you have a servant, if you give him a job to do, and if it's hard for him, help him. Umar ibn Khattab once was walking, he saw Sahabi sitting down and someone standing. He said, who is he? He said, that's my servant. He said, tell him to sit down and eat with you. That's why when the people see the justice of Islam, you know? And hold a minute, do you know we are slaves of the government as well? You know, you cannot marry any man you want. I cannot marry any woman I want. Yeah, if I want to marry a woman from a country, I have to just have a visa. So I have to get approval from the government.
But isn't it for if you bring them here though?
Yeah,
you?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But how is that making them a slave?
No, the government is controlling you. And controlling me. Before there was one person controlling one person. And now the elites controlling one person. Now we cannot travel any country we want. You cannot marry any person you want. If a woman falls in love with a man from Algeria or Morocco, they cannot come here. You have to ask the permission from the government to give you a visa. So the government have to approve it for you. And the government, they can reject him.
But it's not like it's
But no one, sorry, no one speaks about this issue.
Yeah, of course.
Because they're proud to be slave of that. Because why? Servitude is our necessity, is needed.
But
to control people.
This happened throughout history, though. It's still like you cannot marry from your other tribe without the permission of your...
No. Before, you can marry any woman. You know, as long as she's a Muslim or Christian or Jewish Muslim man, can marry any woman from any country before. And before, get up, yeah, before take your stuff, go to Andalusia, Spain, to France, Belgium, no visa, nothing. You don't have to go to the Emir Mu'minin. He said, can I travel? No, you can travel anywhere. Now, before you travel, you need a visa. And maybe they give it to you, maybe not. But no one speaks about this. You know, no one. You know, my sister, the way we've been brainwashed is so crazy. Now we've been brainwashed even to believe that we're free, but in reality we are slaves of our desires. Wallahi, that's what Ibn Qayyim said. فَرُّوا مِنَ الرِّقِ الَّذِي خُلِقُوا لَهُ فَبُلُوا بِرِقِ النَّفْسِ وَالشَّيْطَانِ. They escape from the servitude which they were created for, and they become slaves of their desires and the shaitan. They make you, you know about the sheep mentality? Sheep mentality, Islam clearly against it. Sheep mentality, you're following society because they're doing it. When you read the stories of the prophets and messengers, the prophets and the messengers, they were against the sheep mentality. Prophet Muhammad والسلام, came to people that were worshipping idols, burning their daughters alive. He didn't say, you know what, they're doing it, I'm going to do it. He stepped back, I'm not a sheep, I'm not going to follow. But now, go see the carnival. They're like a zombie. They don't even know where they're going to. Wallahi, where they're going, he's going to drink and smoke drugs. So he's going to harm himself. But they're not going to tell you you're going to harm yourself. What they say to you, you're going to enjoy yourself. Because if I say to you, you're going to harm yourself, if you go, no, I don't want to harm myself. But I say, come, let's enjoy ourselves. If you, yes, I want to enjoy myself. Do you remember Iblis, my sister? What Iblis said to Adam? He never said to him, eat from the tree which Allah made haram. He said, eat from the tree, and if you eat from it, we'll give you eternal life and everlasting dominion. So what he did, he changed the name. Now when they see woman's right, what is woman's right? For man to control her and use her to sell his products. They say Islam oppressed woman.
You know, in this one.
Sorry, I'll keep talking. Yeah, go on.
Iblis did this. Like, you know, asked to eat from this tree.
From the tree, yeah.
Yeah. Who did he influence? Was it Eve alayhi salam or was it Adam?
Both of them.
Both of
Allah said both of them. Yeah, both of them.
But, you know, from since my understanding from since childhood, it's like Christian understanding it was
the Eve. Woman.
Yes.
No. No, they try to blame women everything.
Yes.
That's why they believe, Christians, they believe when a woman gets pregnant, that's a punishment. What we believe is a blessing. It's not a punishment for the woman, it's a blessing. You understand? So, rather Allah mentioned, both of them ate from the tree. My sister, Allah mentioned to us in the Quran, a woman that we should follow. Two women, who knows them? There's two women in the Quran. Allah told us to follow them in their strong faith. Maryam and who? MashaAllah, well done. Asia, the wife of Pharaoh. Pharaoh, who was who? Pharaoh was a man of authority, man of power, rich man. But Allah hated Pharaoh and Allah loved Asia. Why Allah tell us to follow her? She was not deceived by the wealth and the authority and the propaganda of Pharaoh. She believed in Allah. And Allah said, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِمْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ. He said, Allah gave an example for the believers to follow the wife of Pharaoh. She was a true believer. So in the sight of Allah, if a woman, she has a good faith and a man is evil, the woman is better than a man. You know? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, one of the best quotes of Islam is a woman. And I'm mentioning that because there's a lie against Islam. Islam came to oppress women, that is a lie. Islam came to prevent a man to manipulate a woman and to enslave her and to make her